Come on, flat top, he come grooving up slowly. He got juju eyeballs. He's one holy roller. He got hair down to his knees. And but you gotta be a joker. He just do what he please. He got toe jam football. He got monkey finger. He shoot Coca-Cola. He say, I know you and you know me. But it's one thing I can tell you is you gotta be free. Come together right now over me. We'll be right back. Come on, flat top, he come grooving up slowly. He got juju eyeballs, he's one holy roller. He got hair down to his knees, and but you gotta be a joker, he just do what he please. He got Trojan football, he got monkey finger, he shoot Coca-Cola, he say I know you and you know me, but it's one thing I can tell you is you gotta be free. Come together right now over me.
Good afternoon and welcome to the 13th annual Beacon of Hope event, our first virtual event. My name is Mike Condren and I'm the board chair of Marillac St. Vincent Board of Trustees. On behalf of our board, our faculty, our staff, and our clients, I'd like to welcome you to our event. While things may look and feel a little different, over the next hour you're going to get an opportunity to learn a great deal about what we do at Marillac St. Vincent. I want to thank the Foglia family as our anchor sponsor for today's first virtual event, and I want to share with you how dedicated not only the Foglia family is, but also all of our board and staff to providing services over the next 100 years as we had the past 100 years of Marillac St. Vincent. In particular, you're going to learn a lot about the work our food pantries do, and we're delighted to share with you those stories and the particular work that we've done over the last year to really emphasize and help those families in need at a time when we didn't quite expect the amount of demand that we'd receive. Our organization, Marillac St. Vincent Family Services, continues to be a great beacon of hope in this city. And over the past 6 months, we've been really lucky to be featured by Leanne Trotter of NBC5 Chicago in a variety of segments. We're delighted to welcome her today as our host of today's virtual event. And to help facilitate our discussion, to learn about some of the real challenging issues we have regarding hunger in our city. Thank you again for being part of Marillac St. Vincent's Beacon of Hope, and thank you for the participation and support you give us every day to help us serve for the next 100 years.
Thank you, Mike. I am so glad to be here today with you at Marillac St. Vincent Family Services celebrating the 13th year of Beacon of Hope. I first became acquainted with this fantastic organization this summer. I did two stories, one about pivoting for the summer camp and also the e-learning. It was such a fantastic experience. And you know, this organization has been here for people in need for over 100 years, and never has there been more critical than during the current global crisis. People in our communities are seeking food assistance in unprecedented numbers. During the shutdown, and still today, the food pantries at both St. Vincent de Paul Center and Marillac Social Center have continued to remain open and serve the community. Now, all of this would not be possible without the partnership of today's honoree, the Greater Chicago Food Depository. talk about being there, the Food Depository certainly has been for a very long time. And now I would like to welcome Maureen Halligan. She is the Chief Operating Officer of Marillac St. Vincent. She's going to present the award for Outstanding Partner to the Greater Chicago Food Depository. Maureen.
Good afternoon. My name is Maureen Halligan. I'm the Chief Operating Officer of Marillac St. Vincent Family Services. It is an honor to present the Marillac St. Vincent Family Service Outstanding Partner Award to Gate Mayor and the Greater Chicago Food Depository. GCFD is one of the leading voices in the fight to end hunger. Marillac St. Vincent and the Food Depository have been partners for decades. MSV partners with the Greater Chicago Food Depository in the operation of two food pantries, Kids Cafe, and our Senior Citizen Pantry. MSV serves over 10,000 people and their families yearly with the food we receive from GCFD. They provide us with the innovative practice of client choice, which gives our food pantry guests the opportunity to choose food that they feel fits their family's needs. The Kids Cafe, which we've had for over 12 years, provides over 50 Hope Junior children and teens with a daily, nutritious, hot meal, often their main meal of the day. During the COVID-19 pandemic, we have seen an increase of 43% new people using our pantries. GCFD has offered many unique ways for us to make sure the people who need it can receive food. They also offer partners a variety of grant opportunities so we can keep our doors open for people who need it. Hunger and food insecurity continues to affect 1 in 9 people and 1 in 4 children. If food is not a constant concern, families can focus on other priorities, such as education, growth, and security. GCFD, Kate and her staff, are always looking for best practices in eradicating hunger. They work with their partners to make sure we have what is needed to serve people respectfully and in ways that empowers communities. GCFD is well respected nationally and a strong voice for social justice. Marillac St. Vincent Family Services is grateful for GCFD's leadership and partnership and look forward to continuing to fight against hunger in our communities. Thank you so much for all you do and congratulations.
Thank you, Maureen. Thank you, Pete, the board of directors, and everyone at MSV. But a particular thanks to everyone who is on the front lines of feeding hungry people at MSV. The men and women who volunteer and staff the food pantries, who support the Kids Cafe, and who make sure that our elderly neighbors get food delivered. It's all of us together who make sure that our neighbors have enough food to eat. And while I am so grateful to receive this award on behalf of the Food Depository, the truth is this is an award that we should all own together. Every day across this community, our neighbors are turning to us for food. They are walking into the MSV food pantries. Their children are showing up to do e-learning. There are older adults who wake up and who don't have enough food to eat. And as sobering as that truth is, every day there's also this magnificent response. On behalf of all of us at the Greater Chicago Food Depository, our thanks to all of you at MSV for being on the front lines of making sure that our neighbors have what they need to thrive.
Thanks again to Kate Mayer and GCFD, and thank you all for joining us here today. I'm Peter Biel Del Vecchio. I'm the CEO here at Marillac St. Vincent Family Services. And I wanted to just take a minute to give a shout out to all of the departments at Marillac St. Vincent that have been working so hard. They worked particularly hard during our closure. So our food pantries never closed. And those teams have been outstanding and really want to lift them up for all of you. And also give credit to all of our youth services team, the teachers in our early childhood program, our family support team, all who stayed in touch with the various families that we serve. Also to everyone who works with our seniors, also bringing them food and staying in touch, making sure they were getting everything that they need as well. That team, all of them had done just an amazing job, whether it was through Zoom calls or actual visits to people. They really showed the spirit of Marillac St. Vincent, creativity, the resiliency to just take what came at them and figure out how they were going to do their jobs. And everybody stepped up, and we are so proud of that work that they have done. And I applaud them today, and I hope you will do so at home as well, or if you're in your office, wherever you're watching us today. And we're so glad that you're here with us to celebrate all of this fantastic work. I want to thank the Beacon of Hope committee chairs as well, Jackie Langus and Kimberly Walters, and all of their hard work along with their committee that made today possible. And it's been months of labor on their part, and we couldn't thank them enough for making such a wonderful event for us here at Marillac St. Vincent Family Services.
Thank you so much, Pete. I'm happy to be here today with you and Kate Mayer. She is the CEO of the Greater Chicago Food Depository to discuss the increasing challenges of food insecurity in our city and the importance of community partnerships. Welcome to you both. And Kate, we'll start with you. We know that Marillac and GCFD have been in partnership for 40 years. How did it all start?
Well, the truth is it started before the Food Depository, and I think that's one of the things to really lift up. The Food Depository is only 41 years, and Marillac, of course, is much older than that. And the truth is they were on the front lines of responding to the needs long before the Food Depository came into being. But it's one of the reasons the Food Depository came into being is we knew that there were great organizations that needed a consistent supply of food. And so our partnership has gone now over four decades, which is humbling, but also exciting to see where we are today and the impact that we're having together.
And that impact has grown since the pandemic.
Oh my goodness, has it ever. And that is sobering. I think when we reflect back to a time that we'll probably look back at as thinking of as the best of times, we were already doing a booming business together, meeting the needs of individuals and families in this community. But of course, there has been a surge of new people as well as people who were users of the services of Marillac before, but who now need programs even more.
It's really quite sad. Pete, how has the spread of COVID affected MSV and the communities that you serve?
Sure, so on the north side, we're drawing people from all over the city. And then in East Garfield Park on the west side, pretty much in that community, but predominantly the Black population in Chicago. And as we've all heard, the, you know, all populations of color have really disproportionately been affected by the disease itself for any number of different reasons. And so we've seen not only that in the broader Chicago community, but in our community, the number of people who have lost loved ones or the number who are sick really has been shocking. And we see, you know, our seniors that are afraid to leave home. So we've done, you know, they don't go get their prescriptions. They don't go out to get food. So we've done a lot to try and meet them where they are, literally at home. And, of course, all the changes in protocols and everything here. But we've seen a huge increase in the need for the pantry here. I think probably the statistic that really stands out in my mind is that in the first mid-March to mid-April, we saw a 43% increase in the people who were coming for the very first time to a food pantry or people who hadn't needed a food pantry in a year. And so that really told us just how much people were being affected out there, certainly on the health side, but also just losing jobs and reduced hours, making them food insecure and needing someone to step up and help them.
And thank God you're there. Yeah. Kate, what role do the volunteers play in terms of supporting the infrastructure of food distribution?
My gosh, volunteers are the heart and soul of everything we do. I know that's the case with MSV, but that's true across the network that we partner with. Every day, it's the volunteers who have been there, making sure that their neighbors have food to eat. And I'll just say, I think it's one of the really unsung stories in this pandemic. The resilience of community-based trusted partners, organizations like MSV, but also the volunteers, men and women who they themselves may have had reasons to stay at home and make sure that they were protected against the virus, but whose calling and whose mission demanded that they be on the front lines. And we are, as a result, a greater, stronger, healthier Chicago because of those volunteers.
That's right. And it's my understanding that MSV has had many volunteers prior to the pandemic. How have you had to pivot in this time?
Sure. A number of our volunteers were from the community and some of the people who actually used the pantries. And they were in high-risk groups, and so we couldn't have them come. And so we had to do a lot of recruiting of new volunteers. And with people who are actually working from home or people who were laid off, there actually was a population out there ready to come and serve. And so we've gained a lot of new friends who, and just like Kate said, they have been the backbone of making everything work. And we're thrilled to have them, and it's, you know, continuous. Even as people get called back to work, they're finding ways to help out.
Oh, well, that's great. That's really great. Now, I understand you have something called Food Rescue, Kate. Tell us a little bit about that.
We are passionate about food. And one of the things that we do is we collect food from retail grocery stores, from restaurants, and make sure that that healthy food doesn't get thrown away, but in fact can get linked directly to people in need. So 24 hours a day, we have trucks on the road at night during the day, rescuing food from retailers, from stores, and making sure that that food then gets directly to people safely and quickly so that individuals can enjoy the same food that you and I might pay a lot of money at a particular restaurant to eat. And I would just say that linking people to food is so critical right now. There are so many people for whom even that most basic necessity is a struggle to reach.
Mm-hmm. And so when you say food rescue, it's like at the end of the day, if there's leftover food, instead of throwing it away, it would...
Absolutely. So literally every day, Food Depository trucks are going to every retail grocery store in Cook County, and also every Starbucks store, many fast casual restaurants, picking up sandwiches, box salads, using refrigerated trucks, and making sure that that food gets directly to great programs all across this community.
That's pretty awesome. Pete, there's been a lot of discussion during the shutdown about children who typically get lunch during school. Tell us about the Kids Cafe and how you're addressing this issue.
Yeah, Kids Cafe has been a program that we've had here for 15 years. So it's been well-loved for a long time. And in the summertime, it helps with when the kids are here with us during the day. But particularly when it's the regular school year, it's one of the main meals that kids get during the day after school when they come. And it's a hot meal. And right now, we've had to shift to where that's a cold meal, basically a sack lunch. And they are missing, from what I understand, that hot meal. And can't wait till we can get back to it.
But at least you can still feed them.
Exactly. And that's the most important part.
Right.
And as kids are doing their e-learning with us, kids who normally would either be at CPS or a charter school, the fact that they're here with us, the other bonus for them is they know they get a breakfast meal and they get the Kids Cafe.
Exactly. So, Kate, you've said in the past that GCFD is more than a food bank. It's a food justice organization. What does that look like?
Well, I come to this work with this belief that food isn't a luxury. It is a basic human right. And yet, for far too many of our neighbors across Cook County, before the pandemic, it was 800,000 people, and we know today it's probably about 1.2 million people, our neighbors, who struggle with just getting enough food into their household. That is a rights issue. And as I think about who we are as a city, as a country, I know we can be better. It's not just about trucks and food, although that is an important part of our work. And we are so grateful to have strong partners on the front line, making sure that children and older adults and families have enough food to eat. But it's also about lifting our voices. We do not have to accept a world where people have to turn to food pantries, where children go into an e-learning or a traditional classroom without having had breakfast. We don't have to accept that. We can change that, but we have to lift our voice. We have to engage, and we have to change the way that our society operates, because no one should ever go hungry.
Oh, wow. We're still in the midst of a pandemic. What do you foresee the role of GCFD and partner organizations like MSV? What's that going to look like over the next few months?
Well, first of all, I think partners like MSV, Greater Chicago Food Depository, we have a really important job just to make sure that we are on the front lines responding to what continues to be an incredible surge in need. So for the instance, for the case of MSV, making sure that children coming into classrooms, even if they don't look like a traditional classroom, have food, that is so critical. So continuing to be strong and to make sure that food is available. Beyond that, it's really having the audacity to think about what a future can look like so that people don't have to turn to food pantries, so that people don't have to stand outside in the rain to get food. And that's the real promise of the work that's in front of us.
Pete, what do you see for MSV and your pantries?
Well, continued partnership with GCFD, and they've been fantastic through the pandemic and all that they've supplied and going above and beyond. So certainly relying on that partnership continuously. But it's hard to tell. You know, we don't know if there'll be another stimulus bill. We don't know what the next few months will bring. Obviously, it's getting colder. You know, some of the other places that have been able to give out food, we're not sure if they'll be able to continue. The USDA program that's in effect right now is scheduled to end in December. It'll be depleted of the funding for it. And so we don't know if that will be, you know, funded again. And so in terms of our pantries, we're expecting that we're going to see an increased need. And just as Kate said, you know, it's been hundreds of thousands of people who have been turning to pantries that hadn't been before. And so we expect that need will continue. We saw that after the Great Recession in 2008. It was 2 years of increased traffic through our food pantries. And so we fully expect that the need's going to continue for a while.
So what can our guests do today to support and address these issues in the communities that you serve?
Sure. So number one is the volunteers. Like I said before, we really need those volunteers to help us to do the distribution, the packing, the boxes. And so anyone who is, of course, you know, we don't want anybody who's going to put themselves at risk. But if you're feeling comfortable and can actually come in person, either on a day we're packing up boxes or on a day that we're doing distribution, we can always use the help.
Good deal.
And of course, if you can't do that, you can always come and donate online. MSVChicago.org is our website. Whether you want to volunteer or make a gift, you can do that at that website. You could also go to the Greater Chicago Food Depository and volunteer there. And if you do it in the name of Marillac St. Vincent, we get credit for that with the depository. So it's another great aspect of the partnership that, you know, you can find your way, whatever you're most comfortable with. And I think also some destigmatization. Like if you know someone who's on the fence or maybe needs help, like let them know it's okay. There's people there to help you. I think a lot of people suffer and through their food insecurity because there's a little bit of that trying to get over, you know, can I really ask for help? Do I really want to ask for help? And we're trying to make it as welcoming as possible and just know that people are here to help you and that we're going to help you get to that next step. And we're going to do it with our partners.
Thank you, Kate and Pete, for that enlightening conversation. As you can see from our discussion, the need is still great. So we ask you to support Marillac St. Vincent by clicking the donation button to the left of your screen. Thank you to those who have already contributed, and we hope the rest of you will help us reach our goal of $130,000. I would like to take a moment to acknowledge our sponsors today. We have our presenting sponsor, Vince and Pat Foglia, as well as Jackie and Peter Langus, 900 North Michigan Avenue Shops, Ken O'Keefe and Jason Stevens, Diana and Bruce Rauner, Salmon's Financial, Wintrust Bank, and all of our other sponsors who helped us bring you this event today. MSV would not be able to reach our goal without you. Now, you've heard us talk about the importance of Marillac St. Vincent, especially this year. Now, let's see their work in action.
When food brings us together, smiles happen, comfort happens, confidence happens.
Food definitely is magic.
All right, guys, so we're just gonna go ahead and harvest all of these really nice kale.
At Marillac St. Vincent, farm to table isn't exactly having 2 acres. The garden not only is a safe haven for these kids, it's also a learning space.
We're leaving the little ones because they're all gonna grow back.
And I really think that a tomato that you grow and give to your neighbor or a head of lettuce, it really shows you want to not only feed yourself, but you want to feed your soul.
Oh, nice. Two of them, huh?
Being able to plant something, watch it go from that little tiny seed to something bigger than that, it just really shows what people can do if they work hard.
The easiest way to think about who we are is the three different program areas that we operate in. So it's early childhood education, and then there is our youth services. And then our third division would be our community outreach. And so it's really a full range. I think our oldest senior is 102. We're prenatal to 102. So it's the full life gamut.
Hi, welcome to the Marillac St. Vincent Family Services Food Pantry. These are your items. I'm going to go through this.
Every time I come here, no matter what, I always get something that I either need or I want it.
I don't know about you, but when I'm about to eat, I get really happy, especially when I'm about to eat what I want to eat.
We offer a lot of different categories of food, all the cans, fruits and vegetables, beans, ready-made meals, eggs and cheese and milk.
So yes, there is a great need for food, and I believe that the need is greater more now than ever, and what that puts us in a position to do is to rise to the occasion and give people what they're asking for and what they need.
In the city of Chicago, where there's millions of people, there's always great need. And we reach thousands of people through the work that we do. But we wouldn't be able to do that without strategic partnerships like the one we have with the Greater Chicago Food Depository. They make it possible for us to reach the extent that we are able to because of what they bring to us on the sourcing side. And we're able to help them by being the boots on the ground in the neighborhoods. And so it's a great win-win on both sides in terms of them being able to supply to us and us being able to distribute for them.
I'm a firm believer that food is a huge part of what community is and what it means in an individual household. As one of the largest and busiest food pantries in Cook County, we serve between 15 and 20,000 households every year, and we distribute over 650,000 pounds of food. And regardless of the reasons, we are here to serve you and to welcome you and to provide you with the best that we possibly can.
It feels good to know that you have good food on your table, because like I said, there's a lot of people out here struggling that don't have it. So if you can help them with some food or in any way, it really brings joy to their life to able to, you know, help people that's really hurting out here.
I came here to Marillac to pick up some food because thank God that they have sources that allow them to be able to feed us in the community. And I feel like my family just invited me to dinner. My family provided for me. My family made sure that I went home with a full belly and felt good about myself.
Para mí un lugar así está bueno para la comunidad. Tengo un nene Down syndrome que está aquí en el carro, tengo dos nietos. Vengo aquí y me dan comida de buena calidad.
When a child is fed nutritious food, when they are given a good foundation, they're ready to go to school. They'll be able to be confident in what they're doing in their education. It builds the entire family and it creates stability, and it helps them to be successful in the way that they want to be successful. And then that builds the entire community.
I see your firemen, I see your CEOs, I see your teachers. I see whatever they want to be, but it's our responsibility, everyone, white, black, Hispanic, I don't care who you are, is to help them through that and encourage them through that. Some of our kids, they only know what they know in the bounds of this community. And I mean literally within these probably four corners. So let's show them different and help them grow. And again, we go back to development. And development is understanding where they are and help them get to where they need to be.
Being a part of the Marillac family has given me new life in many ways, because there's just a lot of wonderful, talented people, and the love is palpable.
I'm not saying you can do it alone. You were created to establish your place on the throne, to have a mind of your own.
Everyone needs support, and I think that's one thing that people get from Marillac, regardless of what program they're there for. And that is so very valuable.
As much as you want to be the strong person, sometimes you have to reach out, because there are people out there that genuinely want to help. We were impacted by COVID. My father passed away from COVID. I was also impacted. I ended up in the hospital. It just got to the point where I'm like, okay, how am I gonna make it next month? And me not being able to work, I hadn't paid my rent. I was very worried about food. I was worried about my mom. So I reached out to Marillac, and Tremaine answered the phone.
Hi, welcome to Marillac St. Vincent.
And she says, I'm sorry, Adriana. She also talked to me about like a COVID fund where they would give people gift cards every week. The $100 gift cards that I've been getting every Friday that I used to look forward to. I knew that with that money, I wasn't going to lose my apartment. So Marillac St. Vincent to me means hope. It's a little bit of hope.
I've been living here for a long time. Me being disabled, it takes away my life. I had to depend on people to help me get food. Yeah. And you helps me. And I love you so hard.
It's who we touch, the need being met. How can you help that? And that's what's just amazing. That's what's important.
Marillac and St. Vincent have been around for 105 years. Strengthen, empower, and give voice to those in need. That is who we continue to be today.
In Chicago, I have seen pain, and I've seen hurt, hopelessness. But being a part of Marillac St. Vincent, I have had the opportunity to work at enhancing our programs to meet the human needs. We cannot be perfect. We can be better, and that's our promise to our community.
Such impactful work, and this organization could not continue to provide these services without the support of people like you. Believe it or not, this was just a glance at some of the services they offer. I've seen a lot of it for myself. Support is needed to sustain these programs. So if you have not had a chance to donate, we ask you to do so by clicking to the link on your screen. Here to tell you more about the impact your gift will have is Dee Atkins. She's the Chief Development Officer at MSV.
My name is Dee Atkins, and I'm the Chief Development Officer at Marillac St. Vincent Family Services. I'm coming to you live from our Foglia Family Center Gymnasium, and here with me are some of our food pantry volunteers, as well as some staff. Everybody give a wave. Thank you so much. These are some of the people that you heard about and also saw featured today. People who, even at the height of this pandemic, still came out to help us serve communities in need. Some of our volunteers are also like clients. Even Aaron, who said visiting the food pantry was like inviting him to dinner because he leaves with a meal. And you know, Leanne has already asked you to support our mission, and right now, what I'd like to do is share some specific ways that you can help us today. Now, right as we started the event, you already started giving, and that's exactly what this event is about. Prior to the event, we were given a $10,000 matching gift, and you can help us unlock that matching gift right now by clicking the donate button to the left of your screen. Because of our generous sponsors, 100% of what we raise right now, including what's already been donated, will be used immediately for our programs. So again, go ahead, click that button to the left of your screen. Thank you, Mimi. Thank you very much for your gift. Elizabeth, Maureen, Latoya, thank you very much. Thank you for all of those that are giving right now. You know, this pandemic has really changed how people navigate in public spaces. In particular, public transportation. Many of our Marillac clients and families rely on buses and trains to get back and forth to work, to go to doctor visits, and some even to get their children to school. Well, here at Marillac St. Vincent, we offer programs that give that support. If you donate right now at a level of $5,000, what that will do is help us make sure that our families and our clients get the transportation that they need. Again, you provide us with that donation and it goes straight to the families who need it the most. On the screen right now, you can also see other ways that that $5,000 gift will make an impact to our work. Thank you, Angie, Brittany, Maureen, Sarah, Pam, thank you all for giving. We are that much closer to unlocking that $10,000 matching gift. Thank you very much. We have hundreds of children in our early childhood program and even babies as young as 6 weeks old. Even at that young age, we have a curriculum that follows a daily routine that's filled with sensory learning activities, group play, and of course, sleep. Well, it costs us $2,500 to purchase new cribs for even one of our infant care rooms. So I'm asking, donate at $2,500 and help us purchase those cribs for our babies. Thank you, Christine, Mia, Katie. Thank you all for giving. What we know about sleep is that it's essential to brain development because that downtime for a baby really helps them store what they're learning. So click $2,500 now to donate to the left of your screen. You know, since the pandemic, the young people in our Hope Junior program have made positive adjustments to the way that to the things that we do now. It went from contact sports that took place right here in our gymnasium to us helping them really embrace the importance of wearing a mask and also working in our community garden. You saw images on the video, and what I can say is that I've personally watched our garden blossom into this very beautiful space that now our youth really like to spend time in. And sometimes they'd rather be in the garden than inside the building. And there's something to be said about that. Well, because of the pandemic, we've altered our youth activities, and so your donation at a $1,000 level can help us provide 2 months' worth of meals for our young people. Now, the reason that this is important is because we're doing e-learning here at Marillac St. Vincent. And, you know, we know that sleep, like sleep, food is also essential to brain development. So please, at the $1,000 level, give to support our Hope Junior program. There are some people that are giving right now. Thank you, Eileen, Trisha, Donna, Julie and Mike, thank you all for giving to this organization. Also in the video, you saw Sister Kathy. She's one of our Daughters of Charity. She delivered food to our homebound seniors. Now, for seniors, food is especially critical because they don't have the means or the access to get it. And I can say that I've personally talked to Sister Kathy, and I know how incredibly passionate she is about providing food to those who need it. If you donate $500 right now, staff members like Sister Kathy can deliver a month's worth of fresh food and produce to our seniors. And the reason that this is sort of personal for me is because I've witnessed our Take Charge seniors as they've had their luncheons and their dinners. And because of the times right now, that's not happening. Those events for our seniors became much more than about food. It was the fellowship that took place during those events. And because that's not happening, many of our seniors are living in isolation. And so even if it's just the moment that Sister Kathy stops by to deliver that food, it means a world of difference to those individuals who are homebound. So again, I ask you, please donate. Amelia, Peter, Kristen, Heather, Tracy, Robert, thank you. Thank you all for giving. At a level of $250, what that'll do is allow us to purchase a week's worth of PPE. Now, that's a common acronym that we're all saying in these days and times. And PPE has become especially critical for the health and safety of our children, as well as our staff here at Marillac St. Vincent. This global pandemic has brought about a surge in the need for PPE, and our teams are working daily to help us secure those supplies before they diminish, and they diminish rather quickly. It's so uncommon to see people wearing masks and other protective equipment. I don't think any of us could have imagined a need so great and one so very, very necessary. This has become a demand as well as a great expense that grows increasingly at our agency. And again, I ask you, donate $250 by clicking to the left of your screen right now. Suzanne, Peggy, Pamela, Jenny, Jackie, Mandy, thank you all, thank you. That's the way to do it. Keep giving. Thank you so much to everyone that's supporting us right now. Sheila, thank you. For over 30 years, our Project Hope prenatal and parenting program has provided classes and doula assistance. In certain communities, it's really uncommon to even have a doula. That's someone who gives you emotional support during your pregnancy. And some of our doulas are right there in the delivery room with our moms. We're very proud to say that since 1990, we've had a 100% healthy baby rate. If you donate $100 right now, what that will do is help us give baby shower essentials to the mom as they welcome their newest member to their family, as well as the newest member to the Marillac St. Vincent family. And for our Project Hope clients, what we really aim to do is turn somewhat challenging situations into a positive and hopeful future. You can join us in that effort by donating $100 right now by clicking to the left of your screen. Marianne, thank you. Stephen, Deanna, Barbara, Patrick, thank you. Francine, Janet, thank you all for giving. Thank you. Gina, thank you so much. Consider what one of our clients said, Adriana. She was in the short film, and she expressed very immense gratitude for the COVID-19 Relief Fund. That's what we do here at Marillac St. Vincent. $100 a week made all the difference in her life. Click to the left of your screen and donate at the $100 level. Every gift is important. Your gift is important, so please, give what you can. Give right now. They're still giving. Gloria, Stacy, Brandon, Mary Ellen, Kirby, thank you all for giving. The donation link will stay open all day, so if you haven't given already, I encourage you to maybe give at another time, and also feel free to share this giving opportunity. I think Tremaine said it best. We can't be perfect, but we can all be better. So thank you. Thank you for making us better by supporting this mission today. And before you go, I'd like to invite you to listen to our Hope Junior All-Stars Band. And again, on behalf of all of us here at Marillac St. Vincent Family Services, thank you for joining us for this Beacon of Hope virtual event.
CC on the vocals, our amazing trumpet section, these guys on the guitar. All right, what do we have left? Our amazing drummers. What do we got left, Kiara? What's that? I like it.
Thank you. come on, flat top, he come grooving up slowly. He got juju eyeballs, he's one holy roller. He got hair down to his knees, and but you gotta be a joker, he just do what he please. He wasn't no shoe shine, he got toe jam football, he got monkey finger, he shoot Coca-Cola, he say, I know you, and you know me, but it's one thing I can tell you is you gotta be free, come together right now, over me.